भारतम् आभारतम् धर्म अधर्म संघर्षणम्।
On the two sides of the Yamuna flow, the Jala and the Upajala, a king, Ushinara by name, performed a great sacrifice on the banks of these rivers. He belonged to the dynasty of Shibi and so he came to be known as Emperor Shibi. His charitable gifts during the sacrifice won high praise everywhere. He gave every suppliant whatever he or she sought. No one who approached him went empty-handed. Agni and Indra wished to test him. Indra assumed the form of a hawk and Agni that of a dove. The hawk chased the dove. Struggling to escape from the hawk, the dove flew to Shibi and begged him to save it. Shibi took the shivering dove in his hand and said, "Do not fear, I shall protect you." Within a short while, the hawk came there in search of the dove. It said, "Maharaja, this dove is my food. Give it to me." Shibi said, "O hawk, I have offered protection to this dove, so seek something else. I will give it to you." "Maharaja," said the hawk, "the dove is my food. I do not want anything except my food." Shibi said that he could not surrender the dove and that it was a king's duty to protect a suppliant. The hawk insisted that the dove was its food and it would be unrighteous to deny it its sustenance. After a long debate, they came to an understanding. The hawk agreed to spare the dove if Shibi gave it flesh from his own body equivalent to the weight of the dove. Shibi agreed and had a pair of scales brought. He placed the dove in one pan and started cutting off flesh from his body and placing it in the other pan. But wonder of wonders, no matter how much flesh the king placed in the pan, it did not even approach the weight of the dove. Finally, he decided to offer himself to the hawk and sat in the pan. Indra and Agni were immensely pleased with the sacrifice and magnanimity of Shibi. They appeared before him in their true form, blessed him and returned to heaven. The Pandavas and Draupadi were full of praise for Shibi's spirit of sacrifice. They continued their journey and came to Haridwar. Haridwar is the first plain the Himalaya-born Ganga enters. The Pandavas and Draupadi bathed in the holy waters and felt sanctified. Beyond Haridwar lay Badari Kashrama. The Pandavas visited the Badari Kashrama and the Naranarayana Ashrama. The site of the Alaknanda, which is a tributary of the Ganga, attracted them and they stayed there for a few days.